in ProcessBook version 3, there was a new hybrid introduced, a hybrid type of trend called the XY plot. And in the XY plot, instead of having time on the horizontal scale, what you have is another tags value. So you're not comparing a tags values over time, you are comparing a one tags values to another tags values, and hopefully you're comparing them at reasonably close intervals, and we'll show you what we mean by that. If you click on draw and XY plot, you'll notice that the cursor changes to something very similar to the trend object. I'll draw my little square here. And this looks very much like the trend control with a few small differences. First, let's go to the tag search. And in this case, I have two tags on my system that are sine waves. There's sinusoid and sinusoid U. The difference being that sinusoid U is based on UTC and sinusoid is based on my current location as my offset from UTC. And the difference in the tags in plot area is that in the XY plot there's a radio button. And we have to tell the system which tag to use for the x-axis. Now you can compare it to multiple tags. I could have five tags listed here. Whichever tag had the radio button checked would be the one that is the base for the comparison, or the x-axis, the tag that's along the bottom. And what we need to do is determine the data retrieval methods for each one of these tags. So for the x-axis tag on the bottom, we can either use an interpolated method or use a recorded method. Interpolated will get values over a certain period of time. Let's do now minus 2 hours. And it will get those values every 10 minutes. And you can put any value in here you want. If you want a little greater interval, you can do that. And for the additional tags, you'll notice when I click on the tag that's not checked with the radio button, the data retrieval method switches to the Y tags. And these, I have many choices. I can either use the same interpolated or recorded choices, or I can choose to synchronize or match my data to the other tags data. I'm going to use synchronize, which will use the same timestamps that we used for the original tag. Again, I'm going to use my now minus 2 hours and now for my plot time in an interval of 5 minutes. And over in the scale, we have the same options that we had for the trend object. And the plot title, I can call my scatter plot. It's very often what they're called. And when we click OK, we can see that we get a trend object that instead of trending tags values over time, we are trending tags values against one another. And you can see, if I mouse over one of the values, you can see the intersection, the value of sinusoid U versus the value of sinusoid. So my value of sinusoid U is my y-axis, and my value for sinusoid, which in this case is 98.542, is along the x-axis. And up at the top, you can see the coefficient is negative 0.8789. The closer you are to 1 is the stronger correlation. Now, the only differing in the display format and the plot format, really, the most important difference is this last and next to last marker color. If you uncheck match trace, you can set individual colors for the last color and next to last, which kind of makes it interesting because then you can see which direction things are going. And in this case, my last marker color was bright red and my next to last was a little darker red. So you can see that we're moving along this trend in a certain progression, and you can sort of see which end of the trend or which way you're going. So that's of the XY plot.